One is you want to have very, very quick response time. So I'm talking about insane if you can. Now, it's hard to do because you got to be thinking about the staffing and how you do it. But I'm just saying, if a customer reaches out to you via email or text or whatever your service is, if you can get it down to minutes, you win. So I will say with my entertainment company used to have, I tried to respond to all inbound emails and inbound phone calls within 5 minutes.
Wow.
Maximum.
Wow.
Now, as it grew, we were able to hold that line. Different companies I'm involved in now, we don't do it with every company. Some we do, some we don't. But the goal would be to have that response time down to the minutes if you can.
So how do you build a system like that? Do you have a phone, like a mobile phone specifically for that business? Or what? Can you give some recommendations maybe?
Yeah, a very good friend of mine had an internet company that had, we'll just say millions of customers.
Yeah.
And every time that somebody would email in a question, they had a sound effect on the computer that was tied in.
Okay.
And it would go, "Arrgh." And as soon as it came in, they're like, "I'm calling now."
So they're trained. These guys are trained to just hammer the phones.
Okay. So, I mean, you have your daily meetings and these things, you have obligations. Right. And some people need to go to lunch or go to the restroom. But the point is, "Arrgh." I mean, so you would staff, if you're working there 8 hours a day, your number one thing was if you heard a "Arrgh," then you would stop everything, reach out to them.
Top priority. Okay.
So that's a huge, huge deal. That would be a tip I would say. Put a sound effect on your inbound customer service related emails. Don't put it for just general email.
Yeah.
But have an email where you direct all of the customer service to.
Yeah.
And when people email you, and just respond immediately.
Yeah.
It's legendary. Mm-hmm. Now, the second is you want to build a wow experience. You want to build a system that is so good that people go, "Wow." Now, Warby Parker is one of my favorites for this.
Yeah.
So Google YouTube and then go ahead and type in Warby Parker customer service. And we'll see if I can show you an example of what I'm talking about. Warby Parker is the eyeglass manufacturer who is known for. So Warby Parker, what happens is you click play right there. Yeah, this is a actual video pause from one of the Warby Parker teammates, and they had somebody who just bought glasses from Warby Parker, and their customer service team will literally record a video thanking you for the purchase and send it to you from time to time.
Wow.
And that creates the wow.
Yeah.
That's what it does. And so it's a fun thing that you don't expect somebody to say, "Hey, thank you for taking the time to buy some glasses from us."
Yeah.
But when they do it, it's a tech company. So go to their website, warbyparker.com. You just don't expect that level of customer service from a tech company, from a company that's internet based. You wouldn't expect that. So that's why, in large part, why they've grown. They have great products, great pricing, but that customer service is kind of like that third leg of the stool that's propelling a lot of their growth.
Is that kind of the purple cow? Is that what makes them remarkable? Is that the...
I'll put up the quote here on the screen.
Yeah.
So we get the Seth Godin quote.
Okay.
He's a best-selling author. He has a concept called the purple cow,
where
he talks about if you, in a herd of cows on the side of the road, if there's a lot of cows, if you're in Oklahoma, you know, you're probably in Oklahoma. If you're Oklahoma, I mean, a lot of times we have stereotypes about Oklahoma and they're probably all true, but you're in Oklahoma, what's going to happen? You're driving down the road and you're with your mom and your pa and you're like, "Look, Ma, there's a cow." And she's like, "Whatever, there's cows everywhere, honey." But if you see a cow and one was purple, you know, you'd say, "Hey, Ma, look, Ma, there's a purple cow." And she'd go, "What?" You go, "Huh?" And Leroy in the back, he's like, "Ah, son of a gun, it is a purple cow. Pull on over." And your dad's popping a beer while he's driving and he's got a handgun that he just fit. He's like, "Well, let me put the handgun down. Oh, I spilled my beer on myself, but let's pull over." So he pulls over in the car. And
is he going to shoot the purple cow?
In Oklahoma, everyone carries a loaded handgun at all times. And they're always, you know, they got a beer and they're like, "Whoa, look at that. Shimmer, that look, I bet my brisket on this one. That is a purple cow." Some of you, kids, you got any Facebooks we can put that on? "No, Pa, we don't got any Facebooks." And so I can make these jokes because I'm from Oklahoma.